Hi, this is Paul from Elementary Technology, the Visualiser shop. I'm just giving a quick bit of technical support for users who use the Vidifox 3130 Visualiser. The Vidifox Visualiser can work via VGA pass-through, which simply means the VGA cable goes from your PC into the input on the Visualiser, and the output goes to your projector or touchscreen. What that allows you to do is by pressing the computer button, is to switch back to your PC view. So here you can see my PC, so this is my PC view. I press computer once to look at my PC and press computer again, and it will go back to the visualizer view here. Now, what some customers are having problems with, we've realized, is next to that computer button is the ability to switch between HDMI and VGA output. The 3130 also has a HDMI output, so you can connect directly to a screen or a projector again via HDMI. However, in error, if this button is pressed, so what I'm going to do now is press the HDMI VGA button, which is next to the computer button. If I press it once, it will say, would you like to switch over to HDMI? If I press it again, then it will do that. So what happens now is the unit will actually turn itself off, so you can see it's powering off. It's going to turn itself off and then restart in HDMI. The problem that causes for customers is obviously now if they've pressed that button or someone's pressed it inadvertently as a class changes over or something of that nature, they come in, it purports to be on, the power's on, the lights are on. However, you can't see anything because you would automatically think, oh no, it's broken, it's on, I can't view it. So in that instance, if it is powered on, leave it on for around a minute. So if you turn it on and realize nothing's coming through, the first thing to check is leave it on for a small amount of time. So I'll just check the lamp was on, is on. So what I have to do now is do the process I just did, but blind, so in reverse. So I'm gonna press the HDMI VGA button once, and then I'm gonna press it again. And then this time, what it will do is it will revert back to the VGA we were in originally. So give it a couple of seconds. So now, I've just pressed it once, given it a second, pressed it again, and now you'll see the image will come back through the original resolution, which I wanted, which was VGA. So let's let this start up, and then I'll give you one last little tip and trick for managing your 3130 Visualiser. Here we go, just wait for it to start up. So you also have the option with the Visualiser. I've got here a wireless mouse, the USB mouse dongle, but you could use a plug-in mouse. So what I'm actually going to do is, once the Visualiser starts up, so here we go. So again, it's as simple as that. It's not broken, you just need to make sure it's on the right resolution. I can put my USB mouse into the USB-A slot on the Visualiser, and then when I click my mouse, I'll just come out of the way. If I click onto the screen, here we have the settings. So at the bottom right is the settings, and any settings you wish to change are in here. So you'll be able to see, I can quickly look at the, if I go to the settings of the Visualiser, I can actually see anything I need to do. So I've got the name of the unit, whether I want to have it on disk mode, but in this instance, I can go to resolution, which is to set it. So if it's VGA, here are your VGA settings, or HDMI, you can switch to here. So hopefully that should alleviate any problems. However, if you do need any assistance, please contact the Visualiser shop or Elementary Technology.